Hello, animators. Morris Barrier here with a quick tutorial for all of you After Effects CC 2018 users. If you have it, you probably know about some of the great new updates. If you don't have it, pause this video and I'll wait while you go upgrade, because this awesome tip is useless without CC 2018, okay? I spend most of my time in shape layers, so when Adobe announced that you can connect a null object to a path, I got pretty excited because I'm kind of a nerd like that. And what this means is that you can attach other shapes to that null. In this case, we're going to be adding an arrow to a line. So let's get started. I'm going to go ahead and create a new comp, and the duration matters most to me. I'll say 5 seconds. What we're going to do today is add some lines, and I think we're going to draw them on this map. Let me go ahead and tint this, and I'm just going to use these colors that I went ahead and found on Adobe Color Themes, which is pretty cool. I like it well. I'm going to go ahead and take that down a little bit to give a little more contrast. And if you're wanting to know where I located this image, I got it off of pixabay.com. It is a great site for some free artwork, whether it's pictures or vector objects. I will leave a link to that in the description below. And let's see, where do we want to go today? Well, I am in Dallas, so we're gonna start here. I'm gonna click and drag, and I'm gonna go over here to Uganda because it's across the ocean and it's the only African country I've ever been to. So we're gonna do that, and we're gonna click and drag again and kind of create this arc, and then maybe make that a little higher there. So there is that, and we will go ahead and rename this just a line because I'm original, and go down here. So let's start by animating this. So we're going to go ahead and add a trim path to our line. We go over here and click on this go to time where it has the timeline values, and we're going to hit 4. Hit the stopwatch on the end time to get a keyframe. I hit the home key, and we're going to go ahead and make that 0. So it is going across as you might expect. I'm going to hit F9 to turn on easy ease for these keyframes. And something I like to do just to make things a little more exaggerated as far as the speed goes is I hit the graph editor, and if you have the speed graph on, then it will, and you drag this to the right and you drag the one on the right to the left, and now you have a little bit more exaggeration in the middle when it's flying across, and then it really goes slow there at the end. So the new feature in After Effects CC 2018 is not an effect like you might expect, or it's not located down here either. It is located up here, and if you go to Window, and you can access some of the scripts right here, and you'll see this create nulls from path.jsx, and we open that. Let me drag it over here, and what this tells you right off the bat is that this is a script that's going to be run against the layer, and it may add expressions, or it also may add effects to it. And what we have are three things here, the points that follow the nulls. And if I were to click this, then you would have a null here and here, and wherever you move the null, the path would follow as well. And that has some really great uses. We won't be using that today, and I'd like to create another tutorial another time. And then the null following the path, that's just the opposite of it. So wherever the point is moved to, the null will follow also. And then the one we're gonna be working with today is this trace path, okay? And in order to make this work and not get an error, you have to go down into the shape, pretty much a folder, and then you have a subfolder, and then you have the actual path. And the way you'll know that is because there is a stopwatch beside it. And from here, you can click the trace path button, and immediately it creates a null. And so I'm dragging the playhead here, and you'll notice that the null is not anywhere near the playhead, and it kind of just keeps looping through. And that's because this script has added two expression controllers, one being the checkbox, and the other looks like a slider control. And I don't exactly know why they go they add loop by default, but that is what is added. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn that off because I don't need it in this case. The second thing you'll notice is that there's a blue shading on the stopwatch. So what that means is that there are keyframes, and by default it goes, puts it in a 1 second set of keyframes from 0 to 100 on the in this progress. And while it is following this path, it's kind of going at its own rate because these keyframes are overriding and pretty much enabled on their own. But that doesn't matter to us. So what I'm going to do is turn off the stopwatch, and that way we're at zero. And I have this expression here, and because I've already created a 0 to 100 on this trim path, I can just drag my pick whip down here to the end value from this progress, and now it's going to follow it perfectly, and that is exactly what we want. And so we are pretty much set up, and it's all done with two keyframes. So now we just need to add a shape to the end of this, and I'll show you a shortcut that I would do. I could create a triangle or something like that right here in the comp, but really an easier way is just to go ahead and create a new comp, and we'll just say arrow tip. Okay. And I will go up here to the polygon tool, and if I hit the down arrow key, maybe twice, let me go ahead and put a fill on here. So I've created my arrow tip here, and here back to my line comp. Let me go ahead and change the anchor point on here because the nulls always are at 0, 0, and so we want it to be right in the middle there. And I'm gonna hit Command D or Control D on a Mac to duplicate that. And the reason why we create our arrow tip in a different comp is because I can select it, and I can select the null, and I can hit the hold down the Option or Alt key and drag down, and it will do a replacement. You'll see that absolutely nothing has happened. Well, that's because the opacity on a null is 0, so let me turn that up. The arrow is pointing up. And the way you have to resolve that is if you go back into the arrow tip, and wherever the origin is for this, whether it's going from left to right or right to left, you need to fix your orientation of it here. And so in this case, I'm gonna do it 90 degrees and go back over here. And let me do a scale and kind of make this go down just a little bit. It's kind of big. And I'm gonna do Command Shift H to hide. And that way I can see a little bit about what's going on. And you'll notice it's not perfectly center there, and that's because I kind of eyeballed it. And if I go over here to Align, and I select Align to Composition, and I do the vertical, it will kind of move up a little bit, and let's see if that fixes it, and that looks a lot better. And one thing you'll notice that you don't have to do is go over here to Transform, Auto Orient, and you'll notice Auto Orient along the path is turned off. It doesn't need to be turned on because it is expression driven. So this path is already respecting the orientation of this line. Another great thing about this script is that you can go over here, and let's say if you want to make a change and you decide to create another vertices, you can go and add that, and you can completely do it however you want to. And because it's all expression driven, the null or the arrow tip or whatever it is you have is going to completely respect that, and it will follow in the exact same orientation, and it all works there. So that's pretty much all I wanted to show you there. And again, it's all dynamic. If you want to go in here, and I have this little airplane that I want to add, and you make it go and it kind of does its thing. Or so it's kind of that Indiana Jones type look if you're a fan. And you can go down here into the stroke and turn on dashes and you know, turn that up a little ways. And now you got the plane going and it's doing its little dashes. This is a very simple tip. I appreciate you watching this. And if it was useful, please give me a subscribe or a comment or something like that. Any of that is very much appreciated. Thank you, and have fun animating.